about color conversion, the second challenge we have every day. When we have to convert to a specific custom profile, before Color Server, we had to do manual color corrections. After we did our flexo adaptations, which were putting a minimum dot in it or removing it. After that, we applied our color corrections. Many different techniques were used, and it was much proofing, GMG proof. We did the correction again, proofing on GMG, then comparing with the target, readjusting, and so on and so on. Later on, Color Server came, and then we made use of the hot folders of Color Server, where we just could drop one image that was already prepared for Flexo, and we got back an image that was Color Servered or processed with the profile to have a good result. The disadvantage was that we had two images, and it was all flattened into one layer, so no non-destructive working there. With the plugin, all these things were solved. We could have a color correction into one image, and it was on a non-destructive way, so we could keep our layers, as you will see in the demonstration. For people who are not knowing what Color Server can do, a small summary. In the middle, you see the target values. If we should print this with a typical press profile, the result would be like the image on the right side, very pale. If it's processed by Color Server on the left, then it will be printed the same as the target values, because between those images there is a color conversion happening. So back to Photoshop for a small demonstration. I have here this image. When I again put on my bump up curve, I see a lot of problems. When I then look at my separations, I see the main problem happens into the black, where there is a lot of breakouts. So the first step I will do is just remove the black, no black. And then I go to my channel remover again, no black. And believe it or not, but there is no black anymore into the image, but my image stays most the same in color. Only here in this corner, there is some loss of data. So I could make a selection here of this zone just to keep there some black in it. But by removing the black out of the image, this printing problem will not happen anymore. If I then look at the image, it's quite already press ready now for Flexo, but I do have to do a conversion to a specific press profile. So I then merge those two layers to a copy. And I call it CS Color Server. Then go to Color Conversion. And I choose to load my custom profile. This is an MX4X profile made by GMG Open Color. Check open. Then I can check here, replace the assigned ICC profile. Then I can use it for simulation. You will see further on. I press OK. Conversion is done. And you see no difference, because this profile is attached to my image. If I unassign that profile, then you will see, in fact, what Color Server has done. Color Server has put some higher values of color into this image just to compensate the loss of color on the press. So on the press, it will look like that. My image in the coated foreground 39 environment will look like that. I will simulate it with the customized profile and then compare it with the original one. And then you will see hardly no difference, only here where I lost some of the black, but there is hardly no difference. So for that, well, the advantage here is now it's converted to one specific profile. If I have to go to another press tomorrow, then I can just remove this layer, do another conversion. All my flexo adaptations can stay. I just have to redo the color conversion with another profile, and I have my new image prepared for this other press or other printer.